How did rock go from this?
You women have heard of jalopies, you've heard the noise they make, but let me introduce my new Rocket 88.
Yeah. And this? To this. This. And even this. The two sets of clips occupy sound worlds so different as to seem unconnected. Yet, the roots through rock from then to now have been guided by an evolutionary process that seems, in retrospect, to have been remarkably predictable. The focal point of this process was a revolution that almost overnight transformed rock from dismissible music for teens to the commercially and culturally dominant music of the last half century. We track the evolution of the first half century of rock era music from its first stirrings through five decade-long stages, which conveniently all begin with the same letter. Formation, 1945 to 1955. Fomentation, 1955 to 1965. Fusion, 1965-1975. Fission, 1975 to 1985. Fragmentation, 1985 to 1995. And to better perceive why rock was so revolutionary, we profile the pop mainstream around the middle of the 20th century to highlight its striking contrast with 1960s rock. For popular music, the 20th century was a giant pendulum swing from melody at the beginning of the century.
For it's one, two, three strikes, you're out at the old ball again.
To rhythm at the end of the century. For the first four decades, the pendulum swung steadily from melody to rhythm, mainly through the infusion of African musical features. They're heard in ragtime, syncopated foxtrot songs, jazz, and big band swing.
And it looks like it's climbing.
However, a conservative countercurrent that began in the 1930s turned to the past for inspiration, not only to the popular music from the beginning of the century, but also classical music. This return to melody was a devolutionary trend, and it became the dominant direction in popular music after the end of World War II. The most enduring music from these branches of the popular music mainstream enjoyed commercial success and cultural prestige.
Some enchanted evening, you may see a stranger. You may see a stranger across a crowded room.
It's music that many still listen to with pleasure.
That's what you are. Unforgettable. Though near or far.
However, the pop charts were also flooded with more banal music, with about as much substance as the white bread that lined grocers' shelves. It was this music, featured on Broadway, in films, and on television, and enjoyed by a majority of adults, that rock rebelled against and soon rendered passé. Formation, 1945 to 1955. This was the decade in which a new generation of music began to take shape well outside the mainstream. Among the most significant musical developments were the increased use of active rhythms at several tempos and in almost all styles.
Thank you.
More aggressive sounds, both instrumental and vocal. Increasing interest in rhythm and blues by white musicians.
Life could be a dream, sweetheart. Hello, hello again.
Fomentation, 1955 to 1965. During this decade, rock and roll coalesced into a new sound different from rhythm and blues, gained great notoriety, along with the requisite backlash from outraged adults, and increased its commercial presence in part because of the enthusiasm of white musicians for this new music. The new music of blacks and whites continued to evolve through the decade, becoming rock and new forms of black music. Among the major developments were the synthesis of rock rhythm, a new, more active rhythmic template, and its gradual adoption and refinement through the course of the decade. The standardization of the rock band and the assignment of instrumental roles. The transformation of black pop from an inventive take on existing popular song to a pop style that was new in every way.
Are the stars out tonight? I don't know if it's cloudy.
Keep on crying, ready for you. I'm gonna keep sighing, ready for you. So come on, hurry, come on, and see about me.
The merger of blues and gospel in black music. And the use of rock and roll, rhythm and blues, and later folk music as the soundtrack and symbol for a widening generation gap.
The answer, my friend, is a blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind.
Fusion, 1965-1975. This was the decade of the rock revolution. Rock matured into a music that mattered, upended the music business as it gained both mind share and market share, and forced established styles to rock or risk irrelevance. Among the numerous important musical developments were consolidation of the core rock style, exploration of the boundaries of rock style, formation of hybrid styles within rock and between rock and established styles, maturation and expansion of black pop, soul, blues plus gospel plus rhythm, using rock to make an artistic statement through words and/or music. developing a rock era approach to melody oriented music.
I don't know where I'm going, I'm on my way. I'm taking my time, but I don't know where. Goodbye to Rose, ain't the queen of Corona. See me and Julio down by the schoolyard.
And finally, consolidating and commercializing.
I'm a crocodile rock, while the other kids are rocking round the clock. We were hopping and bopping to the crocodile rock.
Fission, 1975 to 1985. In this decade, rock experienced its own generation gap. Disco and punk introduced new sounds and rhythms that were different from each other and from the now established rock mainstream. It was the beginning of the rock era's second generation. Significant evolutionary trends included the explosion of punk and new wave as an underground reaction against corporate rock,
psycho killer, casque say,
the emergence of disco as a new dance music that mainstreamed new rhythms and sounds. Development of a new surpassingly popular pop style. Post-disco funk punk fusions and the emergence of a distinctive array of 1980s rock styles. Early stirrings in rap and techno, the last significant new genres of the 20th century.
I'm close to the edge. I'm trying not to lose my head. It's like a jungle sometimes. It makes me wonder how I keep from going under. It's like a jungle sometimes.
Fragmentation, 1985 to 1995. The diversity of rock era music deepened dramatically toward the end of the century because of the mainstreaming of new genres, the continuing cross-pollination among styles, and a growing generational split within rock. Both old and new became increasingly prominent. Among the noteworthy trends were the classicization of first-generation rock, further fragmentation of rock.
I thought that I heard you sing. I think I thought I saw you try.
Mainstreaming of rap and the increasing influence of electronica.
We've got to fight the powers that be.
sounds made possible by digital technology. The emergence of rap and electronica unleavened with melody in the latter part of the 1980s signaled the end of the giant pendulum swing from melody to rhythm. In both, the focus is almost completely on rhythm and sound. The progression from melody to rhythm lasted almost the entire century. The number beats, the rhythmic templates for four generations of popular music, demarcated the major stages in the overall process. The rock era took shape during the latter half of this progression. A quick recap of rock era number beats highlights how these rhythmic templates played the key role in defining the stages of the rock era.
I heard the news, there's good rockin' tonight.
Oh yeah, I'll tell you something, I think you'll understand.
It also shows how the evolutionary progression that had shaped two eras in popular music had essentially run its course. Furcation, 1995 to the foreseeable future. As a result, the third generation of rock era music was different from the previous two in two important ways. One involved its future, the other its past. Because the rhythmic evolution of popular music had reached an endpoint, the musical way forward was not at all clear. There was no revolutionary new direction around which popular music could coalesce, and the turning away from melody seemed to alienate a sizable percentage of rock's potential audience. In 2017, music rooted in the past, such as classic rock, 80s-inspired pop, and country music, has a larger slice of the market than modern rock. By the end of the 20th century, both rock and black music had furcated along generational lines. Within all three generations, there was fresh music from both established acts and new faces. In particular, those looking to create a 21st century sound have colored their music with new instrumental timbres and blends to distinguish it from the past. Still, we remain in the rock era almost by default, since there has not been a revolution in popular music since the 1960s, and there are no obvious signs of one on the musical horizon. While we wait, we have 7 decades and counting of great music to enjoy.